हेलो एवरीवन, आई पीयूष सक्सेना ऑफ जागरण पब्लिक स्कूल लखनऊ वेलकम यू टू SST क्लास। टुडे आई विल टीच यू अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक ऑफ हिस्ट्री, दैट इज डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द फर्स्ट एम्पायर। इन दिस टॉपिक यू विल स्टडी अबाउट हाउ द महाजनपद ऑफ मगध बिकेम द सेंटर ऑफ इंडिया फर्स्ट एम्पायर। लाइक मैनी अदर किंगडम्स एंड एम्पायर्स, द एम्पायर ऑफ मगध वॉज एस्टेब्लिश बाई अ डायनेस्टी। दिस डायनेस्टी इज नोन एज द मौर्य डायनेस्टी। The Mauryan Empire began to take shape shortly after an invasion by Alexander the Great, who came from Macedonia near Greece. Alexander invasion. Alexander the Great of Macedonia invaded northwestern India in the 4th century BC when the Nandas were ruling over Magadha. He conquered some small kingdoms and reached the river Bias. He could not advance beyond the Bias because his child soldiers were afraid to face the war elephants of the mighty Magadhan army. Alexander decided to return. Before leaving India, Alexander installed Greek governors in the conquered territories in northwestern India. Alexander's invasion paved the way for the rise of the Mauryas. The Mauryan Empire. The founder of the Mauryan Empire was Chandragupta Maurya, who founded the empire around 321 BC. At first, he overthrew Dhanananda, the last Nanda king, who ruled over Magadha. The Mauryas had their capital at Pataliputra. The three most important rulers of their dynasty were Chandragupta Maurya, his son Bindusara, and Bindusara's son Ashoka. Expansion of territories. Chandragupta conquered the territories covering modern Afghanistan from the Greek ruler Seleucus Nicator. Chandragupta expanded his empire to Bihar and other parts of the eastern Gangetic plain, central India, and parts of the Deccan. Bindusara extended the Mauryan empire southwards up to Mysore. Ashoka's empire extended roughly from the Hindu Kush and the Himalayas in the north to the river Pennar in the south. Ashoka. Emperor Ashoka is remembered as one of the greatest rulers of India. It was under his rule that the Mauryan Empire reached its greatest glory. The account of his rule are written as inscriptions in the Brahmi script. It was he who succeeded in capturing the kingdom of Kalinga. Following the victory at Kalinga, he was so affected by the destruction due to wars that he adopted a policy of peace. He called this new policy as Dhamma Vijay. Ashoka's Dhamma. The word Dhamma was derived from Sanskrit word Dharma, meaning religious duty. Its main principles were: first, people should live in peace and harmony. Second, they should show respect and tolerance to all. Third, they should respect their elders. Fourth, masters should be kind to their servants. Fifth, people should follow ahimsa and not kill any living being. Efforts to spread Dhamma. Ashoka issued edicts, which are known as royal orders, in order to spread the message of Dhamma. He added edicts engraved on pillars and rocks and set up in public places all over the empire. The edicts were written in local scripts. Most of them were written in Prakrit using the Brahmi script. In his edicts, Ashoka addressed himself as the father of his people. Ashoka himself toured the kingdom to spread the message of Dhamma. Ashoka appointed special officers known as Dharma Matras in order to interpret and carry out royal orders. Buddhist Council and Foreign Missions. To settle differences in the interpretation of Buddhist teachings, Ashoka convened a Buddhist council at Pataliputra. After the council, Ashoka sent missionaries not only to different parts of India but also to foreign lands like Greece, Syria, Central Asia, and Sri Lanka. The mission to Sri Lanka was led by Ashoka's son Mahendra and daughter Sangmitra. These missions spread the teachings of the Buddha beyond the borders of India. Mauryan administration. Historians have learnt about Mauryan administration and society from Kautilya's Arthashastra, from the writings of Megasthenes, from Jain and Buddhist texts, and from the Ashokan pillars and rock edicts. सेंट्रल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन द किंग वॉज द सुप्रीम हेड अ बिग आर्मी वॉज मेंटेन बाई द किंग इन ऑर्डर टू मैनेज द वास्ट एम्पायर ही वॉज असिस्टेड बाई अ काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स एंड अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ ऑफिशियल्स द ऑफिशियल्स परफॉर्म फंक्शन सच एज कलेक्टिंग टैक्सेस एंड पनिशिंग दोज हु डिसओबेड लॉज प्रोविंशियल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन द एम्पायर वॉज डिवाइडेड इन टू प्रोविंसेज ईच प्रोविंस वॉज प्लेस्ड अंडर अ मेंबर ऑफ द रॉयल फैमिली एंड वॉज रूल्ड फ्रॉम इट्स ओन कैपिटल द प्रोविंसेज वर फर्दर डिवाइडेड इन टू डिस्ट्रिक्ट एंड विलेजेस सिटीज एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन द मॉडर्न एम्पायर हैड मैनी सिटीज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट सिटीज वर पाटलिपुत्र उज्जैन एंड तक्षशिला पाटलिपुत्र वॉज सिचुएटेड नियर द कॉन्फ्लुएंस विच इज नोन एज मीटिंग प्लेस ऑफ द रिवर्स सोन एंड गंगा इट वॉज वेल प्रोटेक्टेड उज्जैन वॉज सिचुएटेड ऑन द ट्रेड रूट टू द साउथ एंड द वेस्टर्न कोस्ट तक्षशिला वॉज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट ट्रेड सेंटर इन द नॉर्थ वेस्ट आर्मी द मॉडर्न आर्मी कंसिस्टेड ऑफ इन्फेंट्री विच आर फुट सोल्जर्स कैवलरी विच आर नोन एज हॉर्समैन चैरियट्स एलिफेंट्स ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड नेवी द सोल्जर्स रिसीव्ड हाई एंड रेगुलर सैलरीज स्पाई सिस्टम According to the Arthashastra, a ruler can ensure justice to his people only when he keeps himself fully informed about the goings on within his empire. The Maurya rulers did this with the help of a network of men and women spies posted within the army in households, trading communities, offices, education centers, rest houses, prisons, etc. Taxation. The cost of running the elaborate administration was met through a system of taxation. Tax was collected in cash and kind. Land tax, which varied from 1/6 to 1/4 of the produce, was the main source of revenue. Other major sources of revenue were customs duty, sales tax, and taxes on crafts and trade. There was water tax too. Welfare measures. The Maurya kings ruled for the welfare of their subjects. As advised by Chanakya in the Arthashastra, the king followed this principle. Whatever pleases the king, he shall not consider as good, but whatever pleases his subjects, he shall consider as good. The Mauryas undertook the construction of roads, wells, rest houses, and canals. Ashoka planted fruit-bearing trees on both sides of the roads for the comfort of the travelers. He also set up hospitals for the sick. Society. Modern society was divided on the basis of professions, such as Brahmins, which are known as priests, Kshatriyas, which are known as warriors and rulers, Vaishya, which are known as skilled traders, merchants and minor officials, Shudras, which are known as unskilled workers, and Harijans, which are known as outcasts and untouchables. Decline of the Mauryas. Factors responsible for the decline of the Mauryan Empire are as follows. Ashoka died in 232 BC. His successors were weak and inefficient. The successors were always fighting among themselves and were disunited. The empire was so large that it was not easy to control the far-flung areas. In the absence of a strong central authority, the provincial viceroys declared themselves independent. Ashoka's policy of non-violence and ahimsa made Mauryan army weak and inactive. Ultimately, in 185 BC, Pushyamitra Shunga, a general of the Mauryan army, killed the last Mughal ruler Brihadrath and established the Shunga dynasty. Thank you.